After getting my entire data science environment set up in VS Code, I spent a little bit of time orienting myself to Jupyter Notebooks. So in this next video, I'm going to introduce you to them. As always, there's documentation here linked on the screen and down in the description below. Now, I'm just going to make sure that the Azure SDK that we installed is in fact accessible. I also want to make sure some of the other libraries that we need are accessible as well. And just to be extra careful, I'll make sure that we have the correct version of the AzureML SDK. We'll go ahead and run this cell by clicking on this green arrow here. And it looks like we have everything up and running. A couple of things to note about Jupyter Notebooks. Up here at the top, you have some actions that you can perform. You can hover over them to see what they are. This fast forward button will run all of the cells in your notebook, one after the other, stopping if it hits any errors. This play button with the arrow pointing up will run all of the cells above the current cell that you're on, non-inclusive. This play button with the arrow going down will run the current cell that you're on and all of the cells below it. This refresh button will actually restart the entire kernel. If you do this, you will need to rerun any of the earlier cells because all of your variables will be lost. This stop button will interrupt the Python kernel. This plus button will allow you to insert a cell. You can also insert a cell with this plus button down here and move the cells with these arrows here. This icon will clear all of the output in your notebook. This will show all of the active variables in your kernel. This will allow you to save the notebook, but you can also just press Control S. And finally, this will convert your notebook and save it to a Python script. The last thing to note is that you can click on this Markdown icon here at the top of any cell and convert that cell into Markdown. And then by clicking these brackets, you can convert it back to code. And finally, if you want to delete a cell, all you have to do is click the trash can. Okay, I think we're actually ready to get started with writing our code inside of Visual Studio Code.